What up, what up, what up? Hi, this is Charlie, and you're again here at Upstream Charlie. One of the best place to be when it comes to DeFi, crypto, etc. And of course, passive income investments in crypto, okay? So I hope you're doing fine today. For those who are already investing in crypto, I hope your crypto is working for you. If not, always change your strategy or always be flexible. So as you can see in the thumbnail, I'll be discussing to you how can you short and when you can short. It means how can you do short trading or short, spear finance. It's pretty easy. You just have to listen to me and watch the whole video, okay? And don't forget to like and subscribe and hit that notification bell before we start, okay? And then let's go to the website of Sphere. So this is Sphere right now. And if you check on their website, so this one is my account, so they have like zero buy tax now, but the sale tax is 25%, so be mindful of the sale tax, okay? So let's go back to the other website. So here is Spears slash USD plus a chart. It's in the 1 hour chart in the DEX screener. So I'm using DEX screener. So far for the last 24 hours, Spear token has been pumping, and it has increased so far 15%. Okay. So if you're not convinced, you could go to Spear Finance. And Spear Finance in Discord and read this, saying that Bernie, meaning the buyback, meaning buyback, Bernie to buyback. Okay, so they got funds right now again, like before, and now they're going to do buybacks. To what their target is, I do not know. So be careful also when you're plan to short trade. If you plan to short trade Spear Finance tokens, okay. What is their other announcement aside from doing the buyback? Now what would Bernie be without his friends Carl and Fred? So, well, Carl and Fred will be joining him soon. Together, they will buy back and burn Spear tokens like no tomorrow. The added bonus to Carl and Fred is that they don't depend on us putting USD Plus in them. As long as Dyson Farm and Galaxy Marketplace are used, Carl and Fred will have money to buy tokens. Okay, so is this an automated buyback and burn? Question mark, right? So soon. So for now, they're doing buybacks again. And they already like another 5 million spears have been burned. So that's minus $43,000 worth of tokens. And yes, this is officially the announcement that they're buying back right now. So how and when to short spear. So, or short trade spear. So for those who are new, just listen. And for those who are months already in DeFi and you still don't know how to do short trading, so just listen here. And for those who are veterans already, I guess you know what I mean. Okay, so when do you do short? Okay, so in this case, Spear is more or less putting itself there. That they are going to buy back. The question is when, right? So from their first buyback, when they already turned the version into version 2.1 by pegging it to USD Plus, they did a buyback officially on July 11 or 12. Okay, I think it was the 12th. Yeah, it was the 12th or 11th. But prior to that, there were like, I assume this is like insider information already. Somebody got wind and they already like buying prior to the official announcement. You could check that again here in their Discord and check the date. Okay. So prior to the actual buyback day and time, there were already like hints or people already got wind. So that's like insider information already. So they got lucky. They bought at the low of 0.003. And with this buyback, it took them around 5 to 7 days. And the peak was around 0.016. That's almost 2 cents, okay? But their actual target at that time was just 1 cent, supposedly here. And then there was a sell-off because people thought that the buyback has ended because they reached 1 cent. Apparently, Sala continued on selling, hopefully to reach 2 cents, I think, without telling people. So they continued on the buybacks here. So the question now, since you already have a record here that, and then after they reached the peak, of course, people were selling off. And basically it went a low at 0.005 from the low of 0.003. Okay, or 0.0037. Okay, so there's a marked improvement, but a small marked improvement from the last low. Okay, at least their price is steadily increasing, but very slow. The only way you could take advantage is that when the price dips again to its lowest, or you have to guess what will be the lowest. So based on this chart, it took them around from the day of B2, they took around 23 to 26 days before they start buying. Okay, so if you do that here, compute again the time it took them to do another buyback. So this is just our best guess. Don't count on me on this one, but it's a best guess. So this one took them what? Oh yeah, 30 days. Yeah, around 30 days and 17 hours before they announce the buyback again. But this one is I'm very curious of this one because there was a big sell here in order to reach a very good bottom to buy back in. Okay, so I suspect that the guys from Spear Finance is sometimes they're up to no good when they're doing buybacks, because people in the inside know what, when and where, when will be the buyback will come. So they're in the advantage because they have insider trading. Okay, so if this happens again, it's still not late. If they duplicate again the same performance here of 300%, I guess it's not late again if you try to short from here and then try to make income of about from here 0.008, and that would be 100% again. However, please take note that they'll deduct 25%, so you'll get 75% net of your earnings or profit. Okay, so be wary of that. The question now is, will they do a 5-day or 7-day buyback from here? because if you probably check the so-called wallet, by wallet, where's that? There's an announcement here that pointed to the wallet of Bernie. Yeah, Bernie is back. So this is the wallet address. Maybe from here you could see how much is the budget of Bernie if you want to check it out. So you would know if it's slowly being drained, because that's the budget for the buyback. If that's how I logically, understand what Bernie is. Okay, it's for you to do more research. And me too. So if this is Bernie and Bernie is the one buying, so the budget is here, right? In this address. So if it's draining slowly, it means they're buying back. But from there, I suppose you could see the budget of the buyback. Okay. So maybe I'll take a look and see later if how much is the budget. So in the part of Simsala, they do this regularly. Okay, so that's the point of this short sale, because we already know that they need to do buyback, because it is part of their mandate to buy back. Because if they don't buy back, people will lose interest in Sphere, and because they're selling a promise that Sphere token can reach $10 in the future. So their initial task was to try to buy back and try to have the Sphere token pegged to 1 cent. But there's so many investors here, and there's so many people who already bought the low, and there are many investors who bought the high prior to 2.1. They like bought at 10 cents, 15 cents, etc. during version 2, and still they're at a loss. So if you're that type of investors who bought it at the high, so, and if you have extra money, this is what you do. You make another wallet, a clean wallet for shorting Sphere Finance token. So for those who managed to buy here and are waiting for this cycle to happen again, the buyback. So if you bought it at 0.5, most likely 0.5, you are a profit already of 54%. So if you want to sell at this rate, you are minus 25%. You will be earning above 25% profit in USDC. Okay, if you want to convert it to USDC or Matic, you could do that in the dystopian website, which is also owned by the Sphere Finance team. Okay. So because if you do the DEX there, you do the swap, so the taxes there or the slippage will go back to Sphere. So 25% sell tax is pretty high if you ask me, but that's how the game is played here. And if you're willing to wait, like other people here who were willing to wait, maybe Simsala will target 2 cents today, or maybe two and a half cents here. So that would be like from the current price of 0.008 to 0.017, okay, or maybe higher, we don't know, because they're not gonna tell. So it's gonna be a risk. Right now you're already in a profit. You could actually sell this and then buy again at this price, okay? Or if you want to risk it, just hold until it reach another 100%, and and then you could like sell. So we cannot determine how high the buyback will become, how high the price will be for Spear Finance. But that's how I can see you could take advantage of the knowledge that they're going to buy back. Okay, that's where you could do the short. Okay, that's how you short. That's how you short, and that's how when to short Spear Finance. Okay. So basically that's it. So if you don't want to buy now, that's fine actually, because they already started, and maybe on the next 30 days or on the 25th day, if it reach something like this, the downward price action, then buy on the 25th day, yeah, 25th day and 26th day, yeah. And then just prepare if you're like awake and you got lucky and there was a big dip, and then also prepare for that. So you have now a chance after this one or during this one to save up your USDC and buy the dip, go through Dystopia and buy the dip on the 25th day after the peak for this current buyback of Spear. Okay, so I hope you get what I gave you. Basically it's a tutorial of how to take advantage, because I know a lot of people like me who bought into version 2 and we're stuck with those, and actually I got fed up and sold my Spear, and I cannot wait because my money in Spear was not making money. So I'm out for a little payback. I need a payback. So on the next round, I'll be ready. I'll have plenty of cash, and I will invest in Spear in the third buyback, actually. So let's see what will happen for this. This will be another historical record for Spear, and this will be part of your research when if you try to short or you try to invest in Spear. By the way, you could also do long in Spear, so, but you know, don't buy too much. Buy like 10,000 Spears, right? So how much is 10,000 Spears right now? So that's like $84, right? So if you buy that, then you'll get 10,000. So that one of these days when they reach like $1 range, you know, you have something in your pocket to buy a Spear. Okay, so if you're like, your budget was like $100 prior to the 0.008 0.005, maybe you'll have more than 12,000 Spears in hand. Okay, so that's my Spear on how and when to short Spear Finance, and don't forget to watch my other videos. I recently uploaded LC is RIP, that's Liquid Capital. Liquid Capital is dead. And then there's another video that the Horde wants to buy Orb or Orbital, because the Orb used to be acquired by LC, and now LC is dead. Horde wants to buy it from via vote by the Orb community, and also through Obsidian. And another story was why Orb was pumping. So Orb just pumped like more than 400% plus, and I told the story there. And and this video is how to and when to short Spear Finance tokens. So that's my video for today. Thank you very much for watching. See you on my next video. Don't forget to subscribe and like, and give us a thumbs up. Goodbye, adios, arrivederci.